Well, it's really wonderful to be back here. I know people are making their way in. We want to welcome you. It is a blessing to be here. We're very excited because we've known Mary Grace for some years now. 11 years, we were counting our years. And she has been such a blessing in our life. We had the privilege of having her in our wedding, and she played for our reception. And so today, to have her here back is just a blessing. She has a gift that God has given her, and all glory goes to God.
I'd like to invite you to bow your heads as we pray. Loving Father above, we thank you because you, all that you create, the Bible says, praises your name. And we've come here on this Sabbath day. We've seen an assortment of your creative works, whether sunshine or rain. And Father, thank you for, you are amazing. I ask that as we spend this time in worshipful music, that your spirit will be here and that our hearts might be drawn heavenward. Be with Mary Grace as she'll be sharing her talents for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. I am so blessed to be here with you today. I would like to share my testimony and some of my favorite Bible verses. Psalm 139:13. For you created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knows right well. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. As you can see, I was born with physical limitations. I don't have a right arm, but a stub, and a right leg that is 8 inches shorter and smaller than my left. It only has 3 toes, and I have to wear an elevated shoe wherever I go. Otherwise, I would limp when I walk. I remembered growing up, it was very difficult. I remembered not having any friends, and some of my loved ones had a difficult time accepting the fact that I was born like this. And as a young child, I really could not understand what was going on, what was wrong with me. Every time I looked at myself in the mirror, I would cry because I looked different from everybody else, and I thought I looked awful. I remember very well the very first day I went to school, I was so anxious, I didn't want to go. And I was right. The moment I stepped in the classroom, the kids made fun of me. They called me names, and every time I would come home from school, I would run directly into my bedroom and cried myself to sleep. However, I am so blessed to have a grandmother who taught me about Jesus and how much Jesus loves me. She told me every time I feel alone, I could just talk to Jesus, and he's going to be there. That's what I did, and Jesus has become a very, very, very best friend, and I don't know what to do without him in my life. I started taking piano lessons when I was 6 years old, and my grandmother had to go through 3 piano teachers before she was able to find one who was willing to take me. She actually made a bargain the first piano teacher that we went to, she told us that I would never be able to play the piano and that I was just wasting my time, both my time and hers. But I'm glad that grandma didn't give up until she was able to find one. And she actually made a bargain with the fourth teacher by telling her, "Why don't we do this? You can teach Mary Grace even with her left hand only, and I'll pay for the price of both hands." So the first few months I played the piano using my left hand only, but later on we realized that I could also use my stub. I modify the pieces that I play. My stub plays mainly the melody, and my left hand picks up the rest of the chords for the right. I used to practice at least 4 hours a day, and there were times when my stub would bleed. I remembered I was giving a concert somewhere in Tennessee, and the moment I played my first piece, my stub started to bleed. I was so nervous, but I prayed. I'm glad that the Lord was there to help me out. From the very first day I started taking piano lessons, I made a promise to myself and to God that I will make every day of my life count for Him. I realized one thing. I was thinking my stub was cut just right. If it were any longer or shorter, it would probably be hard for me to play the piano. I have an elbow joint right here which I could not bend, and I was thinking if it were bendable, then perhaps it would be difficult for me to play the piano as well. And there's like a fleshy protrusion right at the tip of my stub that's just the right size to hit one key. So having said that, I know without a doubt that I was created perfect after all. Here are some of my pictures when I was growing up, and this is me playing the piano. Psalm 17, I am the apple of his eye. Deuteronomy 7:6, I am his treasured possession. Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Several years back, there were people who wanted to introduce Mary Grace to the world. They told me that I could make a lot of money off my talent. I could make that much money that I could buy anything that I wanted. However, They also told me that I could not mention anything about God, nor the ministries that I'm passionate about. They only wanted me to talk about Mary Grace and what Mary Grace can do. So I have to turn them down because I know it's not about me now, it's about God. And it's not about what I can do, but about what God can do through me. So I have been traveling all over. I travel by myself most of the time. And back in 2014, I was going to Boston to, of all things, to give a concert in one of the church's disability awareness programs. I was in Atlanta getting ready to board my flight to Boston. I was on the jet bridge. I don't know what happened. All I knew is that since I am wearing an elevated shoe, if I step on something, even as tiny as a tic-tac, it would throw me off. I was standing, and then the next second later, I found myself lying on the floor, and I broke my right femur. I was in Atlanta all by myself, and can you imagine how terrified I was? You know, I've never been to a doctor or hospital all my life up to that day, and the first 20 minutes, I didn't have any pain, so I thought I was doing okay, and I was even contemplating maybe I could catch the next flight back home because I wanted to be with family in Louisiana. But I prayed and I prayed. I'm glad I decided to stay on in Atlanta because 30 to 40 minutes into it, I could feel the pain. It was excruciating that I could not even lift my leg. So they had to take me to a nearby hospital in Atlanta. My adoptive parents had to drive from Baton Rouge to Atlanta to be with me. That happened on a Friday. They had the surgery the following day, Sabbath. And I stayed in Atlanta for almost a week. After that, we drove back home, saw a local orthopedic surgeon, did another x-ray, only to find out that the bones were not connecting. So in less than a month, I had to go through two major surgeries. I was so mad at God. It took me a long time before I finally come to terms with my disability and my past, what I went through, and something like this happened. But I am so blessed, however, that I have a very prayerful support system. And they made me realize later on that I should be thankful instead. Had it been my good leg or my good arm or had it been my stub, it probably would have been worse. The devil was trying to stop me from serving the Lord, but I'm glad I know to whom I belong. And so we had to go through an orthopedic surgeon in Baton Rouge, and this is the second surgeon decided to put a longer metal rod with 10 screws. So I'm a full-fledged bionic woman now. Romans 8:28, and we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. When I had my surgery, my second surgery in Baton Rouge, this particular hospital, Baton Rouge General, every Friday, they have like a mini concert for the patients, the family, and the staff, and what have you. And when I was getting to have the surgery, somehow this lady who is putting this concert together was there. And my adoptive mom told the lady, this is Mary Grace, that she can play the piano. I saw the piano there at the lobby. And so I played for her, and in my wheelchair. And after that, she told me that probably when I, you know, maybe 3 or 4 months later, I could come back and play for them. And I did. And there was this particular guy. He used to work there as one of the administrators of the hospital. And he was so excited. After the concert, he came up to me and we started communicating through email. And now he is also a musician. He puts on concerts every year in Baton Rouge. And he invited me to perform in one of the concerts that he puts on. And this was back in 2016. I don't know if you have heard of the great flood that happened in Louisiana. We used to live in Denham Springs, and our home took on 7 to 8 feet of water. So we lost our home. And so the concert happened September of that same year. And I got to share my story and all those stuff and what happened. My adoptive mom had an upright piano. And ever since I was a child, I've always you know, wished and prayed that would it be nice if I have a grand piano at home? But I know it's expensive and everything. But anyway, so I got to tell my story at that concert. And after the concert, there was a couple who came up to me and asked me all these questions about my piano and everything. And she told me that I might be able to get a hold of the owner of a music store in Baton Rouge and see what he thinks about it. So after probably 3 days later, she called me and told me that I need to contact this owner. So I emailed him, sent him my story and everything. And a week later, he called me and told me that he found me a piano. And it's a grand piano. And actually, the piano got flooded as well. But it's just the legs and the lyre, they changed everything. And it looks brand new. And everything was free. So the Lord works in mysterious ways. So this was our home. And when it was the water and everything, we lost everything. And it was so scary. The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears them and delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord, surely, sometimes you wonder, you know, why the Lord allows such things to happen to our lives. But He always has a reason for everything. And now I have me a grand piano. And as long as we focus our eyes on Him and we keep the faith, and let us always remember that everything that God allows to come our way is with a reason. He uses even the greatest error and the deepest hurt to mold us into persons of worth and value. And I hope that no matter what's going on around us, we would always focus our eyes on the cross. And one day, when all is said and done, like Paul, we too could say, we have run the race, we have finished the course, we have kept the faith. And I mentioned earlier that I didn't have any friends growing up, but look at what I have now. The Lord has blessed me more than what I could have prayed for or imagined. And all He needs from us is total surrender. If we surrender all to Him, if we put Him number one in our lives, He will work wonders. And these are my adoptive parents, Reva and J.R. Moore. Jeremiah 29:11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future." Thank you, and may God bless us all.
She's not done. We're just going to give her a little break. How great thou art.
O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hand hath made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son, not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great.
So I'm going to ask Pastor Tony to sing The Holy City while I play it.
Last night I lay asleeping, there came a dream so fair. I stood in old Jerusalem beside the temple there. I heard the children singing, and ever as they sang, methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang. Methought the voice of angels in heaven answer rang. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, lift up your gates and sing. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna to your My dream was changed, the streets no longer rang. Hushed were the glad hosannas, the little children sang. The sun grew dark with mystery, the morn was cold and chill, as the shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. As a shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. Jerusalem, hark how the angels sing. Highest, Hosanna to your King. And once again, the scene was changed. New earth, there seemed to be. I saw the holy city beside the tideless sea. The light of God was on its streets, the gates were opened wide, and all who would enter, and no one was denied. No need of nor stars by night, or sun to guide by day. It was the new Jerusalem that would not pass away. It was the new Jerusalem that would not pass away. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, sing for the night is o'er. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna forevermore. Hosanna for
the last piece I will be playing, my tribute. I usually end my program with my tribute, or "To God Be the Glory," because I know very well that I won't be able to play the piano without the Lord. No matter what accomplishments I may have in this world, I cannot take any credit out of it, because only God gets the honor and glory. And the only reason why I am here standing in front of you today is because of His love, mercy, and grace. And for that, how can I say thanks for the things you have done for me? Things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. All that I am and ever hope to be, I owe it all to thee. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. And to God be the glory for the things He has done for each and every one of us. Thank you. God bless.